All right, so like we discussed before, here we've marked out the border of the mandible, and then 1 inch medial to those lines, marked out the area that you don't want to go because you want to protect the marginal mandibular nerve from injury, marked out the anterior border of sternocleidomastoid, and then the limits of the submental adiposity on either side, and then you have the thyroid notch, which sort of corresponds to the cervicomental angles. This delineates the area that you're going to treat with the Kybella. These dots come from a matrix, a grid, that is applied as sort of a temporary tattoo to her neck to guide where the injections go. They're spaced 1 centimeter apart. And for those dots that fall along those lines that you've marked out, you don't want to inject along those lines. So here we're talking about just the dots that have fallen within the confines of that area that you've marked out. And in her case, there are 17 of those dots within this area. So you're going to want to use that corresponds to 3.4 cc's of Kybella, 200 microliters per injection site. Right? This is pretty much a Botox setup. So we inject these with a tuberculin needle or a 1 cc syringe with a 30 gauge needle. We're targeting the preplatysmal fat. This isn't a deep injection. This is fat that is superficial to the platysma. You don't want to inject beyond that. And we're going to get started here soon. All right, you want to pause that. You don't want to place that needle through these dots in this temporary tattoo, because that could potentially tattoo the skin. So inject just adjacent to, or just beside, the dot. Our patient has some topical numbing on board. And then Sophia. We want this injection parallel to the skin. I've come a little off of parallel just to get my hand out of the way so that you can see what I'm doing here. Being facial plastic surgeons, we work in the neck frequently, and it doesn't take a stretch of the imagination to know where that preplatysmal fat layer is. That's what we're targeting. So you can go perpendicular to the injection port, perpendicular to the skin, just off center if you need to get your hand out of the way. Either way, just make sure that Kybella ends up in the preplatysmal fat. I do think it's important that the injector not take their eyes off of the neck so as not to lose track of where you've injected. Again, 0.2 of a cc per dot. Thank you. Ice pack, please. So you can see there's minimal bleeding. Apply an ice pack for this injectional tenderness that the patient may have. A little bruise may appear at 1 or 2 or 3 of the injection sites, nothing to be concerned about. These injections are routinely done now across the country in patients who are on therapeutic Coumadin and blood thinners like that. So it's, worrisome bleeding is not a concern for this procedure. And there you go. That series of injections took maybe 4 minutes or so. It's not the sort of thing that takes a long time to do. Getting the patient prepared, marking out the borders of the injection area, applying the grid. It takes a little bit of time preparing for the injections, but overall it's a fairly rapid procedure. Sophia, how would you say that rated on a pain scale?
Between 1 and 10, I would probably say a 4 to 5.
Okay.
Not really the actual injection itself, but you can feel the burning.
Right. And you can expect that burning will persist to some degree for 2 to 3 days after the injections. That pain is readily controllable with over-the-counter pain medications. You can also expect that there will be some swelling at this area. That also increases over the subsequent 24 hours and usually resolves within 4 to 5 days after the injection. Okay.